My name is Tanya Paul, and I'm the Isabel and Alfred Bader Curator of European Art at the Milwaukee Art Museum. And I wanted to welcome you today to the first in a series of video conversations that we're beginning called Collection Reflection. In this series, we are exploring thematic links that cut across traditional curatorial subdivisions within the museum's collection in order to create connections across that collection at a time when we are both physically separated from it as well as from one another. So our first topic or theme that we're going to explore is the notion of still life and how artists have both created and explored still lives across time and across media. So I'm going to begin the discussion with an exploration of an 18th century Dutch still life by the artist Jan van Os. As you can see, this is a beautiful flower still life. It's set in an outdoor setting and it is luscious and full and expressive. And at first glance, you might assume that it is purely decorative. And it is that. The thing that I love about this painting is that it's actually much more than that. And when you really start to study it more deeply, you realize that there's much more going on. So I wanted to look at this painting more closely with you and start to peel back those layers. So one of the first things you start to understand about this painting is that what Van Os has created for us is in fact an impossible bouquet, a bouquet that never could have existed in nature. And we know this when we start to look at the flowers that he's chosen to depict. So we start looking in the upper left-hand corner where you see the beautiful scarlet-orange fritillaria with its downward hanging bell-like flowers. On the right-hand side of the composition at the center is the familiar purplish-blue iris. And then at the bottom left, of course, is the classic white tulip with red flamed edges that we think of as such a national symbol for the Netherlands. All of these flowers are springtime flowers. We actually associate them with precisely this time of year, this time of new life and rebirth and emerging from a cold, forbidding winter. And so these are wonderful springtime flowers. But alongside these springtime flowers, Van Os also includes other flowers, namely the beautiful white carnation with red accent colors, beneath it the wonderful scarlet marigold. Next to that is the beautiful spike of a purplish-blue delphinium with its multi-flowered stem. And then at the very bottom of the composition is the beautiful chalky pink cabbage head rose. All of these flowers are truly staples of a summertime garden. So right away, we understand that those spring flowers and these summer flowers never exist in nature at the same time. They are months apart. So what Van Os is creating for us is a record of flowers that exist across time and space. So this painting immediately becomes a meditation on time and the seasons and the passage of time. That becomes all the more self-evident when you notice other elements of the composition. Namely, in the bottom left, he has depicted a wonderful bird's nest with a little clutch of eggs sort of nestled down in and amongst the downy bird feathers. You actually see the parent bird perched further up in the bouquet. And so you see this lovely nest and these eggs, which are truly the ultimate potential for new life. And you understand that, again, this painting is sort of stressing these ideas of new life, rebirth, and the passage of time and the seasons. And so you understand that much like the flowers are ephemeral, they bloom, they ultimately wilt and die, So are birds and birds' eggs, which of course we hope will hatch into young birds, which will ultimately fly away and go on to live their lives. So there is this continuity of association across these various elements that pepper the composition, and that Van Os is deliberately grouping together in a single painting. his awareness of his role in creating this larger meditation on time and on seasonality becomes all the more clear when we notice other elements of the composition. Namely, on the tulip in the bottom left, that spring flower we considered before, you notice it, of course, it's a beautiful flower, but you also notice that sitting on the tulip is a big black fly. And that black fly is a wonderfully playful element, because there is a moment when, as a viewer, you see the fly and you are torn. It's unclear whether the fly is sitting on the tulip itself in the composition or whether the tulip is sitting on the painting surface. So you are unsure whether you should admire the illusion or swat the fly away. Similarly, the droplets of dew that Fonos has painted on the tulip surface have the same kind of push and pull quality to them. Fonos underscores his awareness of that kind of playfulness, of the role he's playing in this sort of fictional construct of a composition, finally in the way that he signs his painting. So he signs the painting along the stone plinth in the bottom of the composition. This seems fairly straightforward until you realize that rather than signing his name simply and in script or what have you, he actually signs his painting in an illusionistic fashion to look as if it is actually carved into the stone plinth. So even his own name and his own identity become this playful addition to the composition. So ultimately, this painting is a meditation on the passage of time. It is a meditation on the seasons. It is a meditation on life and the ephemeral. And it is a meditation on artistic self-consciousness and artistic self-awareness. It is a beautiful painting. I really hope you have enjoyed this discussion. And if you are interested in seeing more discussions from either this thematic link or as we develop them, more thematic connections, just go to our website, nam.org, and look for this series, Collection Reflection. Thanks.